Today's discussion is about COVID exposure. As the numbers of confirmed COVID-19 cases and related hospital admissions continue to rise, so, too, does the risk of potential exposure. But what actually constitutes exposure to the novel coronavirus? How does contact tracing help identify who has been exposed to COVID-19? And, what should you do if you learn you've been exposed to COVID-19?
Today I am talking to one of the efficient doctors in UK. Hey Lizzie. Welcome to today's discussion section about COVID.
Hello, thank you Mr. Nate Johnson.
Tell me about COVID and what constitutes close contact and what constitutes exposure to the coronavirus?
Close contact to COVID-19 occurs when a person is within 6 feet of someone who is showing symptoms of COVID-19 for at least 15 minutes, when neither person is wearing a mask, and the infected person later tests positive for the coronavirus. This can also apply to situations in which the infected person did not show any symptoms at the time of exposure, but it is much less likely. If either or both individuals were wearing face masks, it is not considered exposure.
For about risk factors, what is the difference between indoor and outdoor settings?
Outdoors, your risk is a bit less, because you are not in a confined area with poor air circulation. But regardless of whether you are at inside or outside events, you should still be wearing a mask and practicing social distancing. And you should wear a mask anywhere you can't guarantee you'll be able to stay 6 feet away from other people. Don't forget to frequently wash your hands.
After exposure to COVID, what he or she should do?
Quarantine himself for 2 weeks. That means staying at home and away from other people for 14 days after the date of the exposure, while the person monitor himself for fever and other signs of infection. If they live with other people, sleep in a separate room, if possible, avoid sharing food, frequently disinfect surfaces, and try to avoid the rest of your household as much as possible. The person should wear a mask in his home when he is not able to properly keep distance from other household members. If he don't show any symptoms after 2 weeks, he can venture back out again if necessary, but be sure to wear a mask, practice social distancing and wash hands frequently.
At what point do I need to get tested for COVID-19 if I've been exposed?
You can be tested for COVID-19 at any time, but keep in mind that the tests are more reliable when people are actually showing symptoms of infection. So, if you've been exposed and are showing COVID-19 symptoms, that would be the ideal time to get tested. We recommend the COVID-19 nasal swab test, which is the most reliable test at this time.
What about the disease symptoms?
The list of COVID-19 symptoms continues to evolve as we learn more about this coronavirus, and symptoms can vary widely from person to person. At this time, these are the COVID-19 symptoms you should watch for: fever, cough, any new shortness of breath or difficulty breathing, chills, shaking with chills, muscle pain or body aches, headache, sore throat, loss of taste or smell, diarrhea, nausea or vomiting, congestion or runny nose, and fatigue.
What is a COVID cluster?
This is defined as two or more people who shared the same space at the same time when they developed symptoms and who subsequently tested positive for COVID-19.
What does the same space mean? Could that be my home?
It could be a residence, but it could also be any other type of gathering, whether it's strangers at a bar or friends and family at a pool or a birthday party. Even people sitting around a break room at their office could be a cluster, if two or more of them started showing symptoms and later tested positive for COVID-19.
What is contact tracing, and how does it work?
Contact tracing is an attempt by public health officials to identify situations in which an infected person is transmitting the coronavirus, and then warn others who may have been exposed through that person. This way, those who've potentially been exposed to COVID-19 can quarantine themselves in the hopes of reducing the spread of this coronavirus. Here's how contact tracing works. First, officials contact the infected person to get details of where and how they might have caught the virus. Then, they try to determine who that person might have exposed through close contact, based on the definition above. From there, they contact the people who were exposed and ask them to quarantine themselves until the danger has passed.
How far back in time does contact tracing go?
There has been no clear guidance on that yet, but generally speaking, contact tracing goes back about 2-3 days before infected people started showing symptoms.
What's the most important thing for people to know about COVID-19 exposure and contact tracing right now?
Contact tracing is very complicated, even when you have adequate resources. So, the best thing you can do to protect yourself and others is continue to wear a mask, wash your hands, practice social distancing, and stay at home whenever possible. And if you have COVID-19 symptoms, go home, quarantine yourself and get tested.
The British have a large randomized trial out of the University of Oxford. That's the one that showed definitively that hydroxychloroquine didn't work and that unfortunately one of the anti-HIV drugs didn't work either. But it also showed that dexamethasone did work and very, very quickly because it's such large numbers. They are studying convalescent serum too. Why haven't they got equally fast results from their study there? Because that could give a very definitive result.
Yes, absolutely. Partly because the numbers in the UK have reduced, as in numbers of COVID patients, and so they haven't been able to accrue as quickly and generate the data as quickly for convalescent plasma.
Thanks very much for your time. Okay, bye.
Thank you. Bye. Subscribe our channel for getting more videos. Also please like and share. Thank you.